Good morning, respected teacher. I am Keya Jan of class 6C. Today I am going to share the book talk that I wrote for the wonderful story The Auto That Flew. Its author is Ken Spillman and its illustrator is Ajanta Guhata Kurta. So let's begin. The story is about a hard-working and wonderful auto. Its name was Arjun. He had three wheels, one headlight and a coat of green and yellow. He belonged to the largest family in the whole of Delhi. Everywhere Arjun went, there were brothers, sisters, aunties, uncles and cousins. It worked hard day and night. He went foot, tuk-a-tuk-a-tuk, all day driving from place to place, delivering people to different destinations. It never ever complained, as its owner, Autowala Sirishji, worked hard too, despite having old bones that caused him pain all time. He decorated Arjun's dashboard with plastic flowers and pictures of movie stars. He quenched Arjun's thirst for clean gas, even when the queues were long. And whenever Arjun's canopy was torn, he wasted no time in taking it to be patched. It loved to take tourists to different places such as Lajpat Nagar Market, Connaught Place, Feroz Shah Kotla and many more. Its heart sang when people chose three wheels over four and also loved to rest with Shirishji in the shade of a tree outside Qutub Minar. Life was good and Arjun knew it should never wish for more, but secretly he wished for more and his wish was to have helicopter blades and fly. He used to dream about if it could fly, they would chop the air above its canopy. Sirishji would wrap his head in a scarf and the ends of it would flap gaily in the breeze. But Arjun knew that it is a dream and would be that only. An auto having helicopter blades would be like an elephant having wings or a train that could zoom off into space like a rocket with its carriages trailing behind. One hot day, Arjun was waiting in a hodgepodge of traffic at a busy intersection when a grubby boy came squeezing between cars and autos selling water. He called out, "Magic water, would you like?" The old woman with grey hair in the auto as the visitor decided to have some water as she and Shirishji were thirsty. She produced some rupees and took two bottles from the boy. Immediately, she handed one to Shirishji. Shirishji smiled broadly, showing the woman his pan-stained teeth. He drank quickly and the traffic buzzed. The old woman and Shirishji drank, spilling a little on Arjun as he started forward. Arjun also moved as beeping a cherry hello to one of his brothers as traffic buzzed. No sooner were they moving than Arjun began to feel light on his wheels. Suddenly, the old woman's sari carried a brilliant sheen embroidered with fine gold thread that was totally opposite to the dull color of her sari before. Arjun's wheels lifted off the road and up, up and up it went, flying into the blue sky. It was pure magic. The water was really magical. Arjun's headlight lit with joy. During its amazing flying journey, Arjun flew high above Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium and India Gate. It looked upon Humayun's tomb, the Yamuna River and the gracious temple of Akshardham. It saw a giant web of roads like the work of a crazy spider. When Sirishji looked at his face in the front rear view mirror, his face wasn't filled with freckles or agent line anymore. Instead, he had radiant skin with teeth that shone like white pearl which were before pan stained. He looked like a Bollywood hero. It was so unbelievable, but it was true magic. But soon Arjun started to miss the life in the roads. He missed the life of roads jammed with cars, motorcycles and buses. He even missed the rush and bustle of people, also eager to arrive somewhere else. Even the old lady started to miss the world below. The old lady was impatient to meet her daughter and grandchildren whom she was going to meet. They were true magic for her. Sirishji was also tired of his Bollywood face. He wondered what was the use of this radiant skin. All he wanted now was the comfort of his own old skin. It was true magic for him. Arjun slowly came back to earth. The magic was faded away for everyone. Sirishji was very happy to hear the hustling and bustling of the city again. Arjun was happy to meet its family again and go to different destinations delivering strangers and exploring the city. The woman's grandchildren waved happily from the window of a house nearby. Arjun was much delighted now, as every ride would be new, part of his endless journey full of surprises. I hope you liked this book talk. My review for the story is that it is a wonderful story. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.